How's it going, everyone? Today I'm going to be taking a road trip to San Diego, California, which is about 350 miles from where I live in Phoenix, Arizona. And I figured I'd film a vlog because I love doing road trip vlogs. They're always fun. So oddly enough, I've owned this car for about, I think, over 5.5 years now. And until I made this exact drive about a month and a half ago, I hadn't ever taken it out of the state of Arizona. So this is actually only the second time the car is ever leaving the state of Arizona. Now, when I did this drive last time, the car was absolutely perfect, flawless. So before we head out today, I wanna check tire pressures, all the fluids, basic things like that, just to make sure we're good to go. Also make sure the spare tire is pumped up. But on the road trip itself, there are a few things I wanna talk about. Now, in my last video, I installed this bug deflector right here, and I said that in my next video, meaning this video, I was going to actually test it. So that's what we're going to do today. I got the windshield all cleaned off last night when I filled up with gas. Unfortunately, I haven't had time to wash the car, so there are some existing dead bugs on here, but really almost none, not as many as you'd see on a road trip. Especially there's some on the front end too, but you know, that's just because the car hasn't been washed in 3 weeks. But I really want to see how well this works, if it can actually prevent bugs from getting on the hood. I think it would prevent them from getting on the hood, but we'll have to see if it can also prevent them from getting on the windshield as well, because the windshield is what always gets hit really bad on these cars. And then I just want to talk about the MPG of the car, how it does over this drive, and basic little things like that. So it should be a fun time. I'm really looking forward to it, so hopefully you guys are going to enjoy all the b-roll and just the fun of a road trip vlog, because road trips are always so fun. So yeah, without further ado, I'm gonna go ahead and check these things off camera. And let's hit the road. All right, so here we go. We've got 5 hours, 17 minutes, 363 miles, full tank of gas, but we will definitely be filling up in Yuma, which is on the border here between Arizona and California. We'll be stopping there to get gas because gas is very expensive in California, and it's like a good halfway point to stop, get some lunch. So yeah, first stop, hopefully Yuma. Let's go. I'm also gonna clear my MPG to reset that, see what we can get for this trip. Honestly, once it warms up a little bit more, I'll probably turn the AC off and just drive with the windows down, so that'll hopefully improve my gas mileage a bit. But yeah, let's hit the road.
I used to walk these roads with you. Remember the last time I went without you.
Just made it to Gila Bend, which is the first kind of stop before we hop on Interstate 8, which finally means no more one-lane road, so I won't be stuck behind slow drivers anymore. But all these bikers cruising around like they own the damn road as always, you know, waving to each other, doing their dumb shit. He's not gonna let me in front of him here, probably. So yeah, it's great, but so far we're averaging just about 31 mpg, so pretty solid, but I'm probably gonna turn the AC off here, crank the windows down now that it's warmed up a bit, and we're definitely gonna be going a bit faster, so I suspect that number will drop, but 31 mpg, not bad. I'm sure you diesel guys are gonna say that you get way better than that, but I mean, it's good for what I got.
In 1 mile, keep right to merge onto I-8 west towards San Diego.
Now we're gonna be on I-8, but to San Diego. This 150 mile or so stretch between Gila Bend and Yuma, Arizona, which is on the border of California, is a whole lot of what you're seeing right now. Nothing really interesting worthy filming b-roll for. So I'm gonna go ahead, shut the camera off, and I'll catch up with you guys when I'm in Yuma. We'll get some lunch, fill up on gas, and I'll talk to you guys about some of the things I hinted to in the intro of this video. Been about an hour since I last filmed. I'm about 15-20 miles outside of Yuma, and my cruise control just randomly shut off, which usually means that the car put itself in the limp mode and is going to throw a check engine light here soon. So I'll have to keep you guys updated on that. Hopefully it's just the standard P0101, which is a math code I get every now and then for the K&N filter I have in there. But yeah, so interesting development for sure. I'm now without cruise control until I stop. Now if I restart the car, it'll take it out of limp mode, but it'll probably throw a check engine light shortly after that. So when this kind of stuff happens, I just hope the car gives me a code, because it just makes it easier. Kind of eases the stress, because then you know what's wrong. I always have my OBD2 reader in the trunk just in case something like this happens. So I guess we'll see. Hopefully it gives me a code. So just got to Yuma. Car didn't throw any check engine light. So when I restart it here, it should be out of limp mode. But just a quick update looking on this. Besides that, car was perfectly fine. Definitely got a lot of bugs down here and everything. The bug deflector seems to be doing its job though. Got a good amount of bugs spread across here. When I'm looking on the hood, I don't see a single new bug on the hood. Not a single one that wasn't there before. The windshield, of course, has gotten its fair share of bugs. That one hit me like right when I got off the interstate just here. But I'm just letting the car cool off, run for a couple minutes, since it's been running at 90 miles an hour for the last 2 hours pretty much. 28.3 mpg we're down to. I did actually put the windows up after about 30 minutes. It started to get a little hot. So yeah, I'm gonna go ahead, fill up on gas though, and we'll go grab some food. I am going to get gas like right here at the entrance of Yuma, and then the food is gonna be about another 10-15 miles in, closer to the California border. And hopefully within that 10 or 15 miles, we can get a check engine light, because I don't want to have to get a check engine light when I hit the road again in California. But anyways, that's enough talking. Let's fill up. Gas is about the same price here as it is in Phoenix, so not too bad. Definitely about a dollar cheaper a gallon than it would be in California though. So usually what I try and do when I do this road trip is it's about 180 miles to Yuma, then about 180 miles to San Diego from Yuma, is I'll fill up full tank in Yuma, and I'll usually have to put like $20 worth of gas in California, and that'll be enough to get me back to Yuma, where I can fill up at Arizona rates. But even this, the Europeans are gonna say, oh my gosh, it's so cheap. It only took 6 gallons we burned so far, so that's pretty good. I'm averaging just under 30 miles per gallon, so it makes sense. I just drove around 10 miles to get lunch here at Chipotle, which is kind of like the go-to lunch spot here whenever you're taking a road trip. So no check engine light, car drove completely fine, so I guess we're just gonna have to send it. Hope she's fine. If it does get a check engine light, then we'll go from there. But for now, let's go get some lunch.
20 minutes later.
We've got about 2 hours, 45 minutes left, just under 200 miles, so let's get to it. So as we're hopping on the freeway here, I guess we can start talking about some of this stuff if people would actually go. It's a green light. It's green. Green means go. Go. Sorry, there have been a lot of stupid drivers so far, particularly on that first stretch, and also a good amount on I-8, especially once I got into Yuma here. But we're gonna cross over the California border here in a minute, and right after we cross over the California border, we'll be right by the U.S.-Mexico border, so you'll actually be able to see Mexico in the wall from Interstate 8, which is pretty cool. There's a short stretch where you're probably about a quarter mile from it. So yeah, I'll try and get that on camera. I want to talk about a couple of life-related things and how that's affected the channel as of late, because I don't want to necessarily say what's been going on in the background the last 3 or 4 weeks. I kind of want to just drop it on the channel and you know, surprise you guys, I guess, even though it's not like it impacts you at all. It's a huge deal for me. So I've been working on what that is literally every night after work for the past 3 or 4 weeks, it feels like. So because of that, I feel like my videos haven't been as fun as I'd like them to be, so I apologize for that. But hopefully once it's settled, which should be around the Thanksgiving, which for those of you that don't live here, don't know when Thanksgiving is, towards the end of November. So hopefully by the end of November, we'll be able to get things sorted a little bit better, start getting back to making some fun repair videos. Might have a repair video coming depending on this check engine light and what it is, if it comes back or if it even comes on. But yeah, so we're about to cross over the Colorado River right here, and that is pretty much the border between Arizona and California, which means that I am officially now lost an hour with daylight savings time having started. There's a little bit more of a beautiful sign, I guess you could say, for California. So officially in California, we're going to be going through some sand dunes here. That'll be by the border, and then it'll get very boring for a while again, and then we'll start going through some mountains, which are some of the coolest mountains. That's a nice color on that Grand Cherokee. We'll start going through some mountains and some very interesting mountains, and once we get to the top of that, which is around like 4,500 feet, then we'll start going back down towards San Diego and the beach. The only thing that does suck about this car, driving it on road trips, is that this exhaust drones. So when you have the windows down or you got music playing past a certain volume, you don't hear it. But if you're just sitting here and kind of like we are without any music on, you can hear the drone. It's not too bad right now, but especially once you get up to around 90 miles an hour, and 90 has been what I've been cruising at, it gets pretty loud. Anyways, I'm going to shut up. That was just a little bit of an update I wanted to provide you guys with. So yeah, I guess back to the B-roll and the fun road trip footage. And you'll see the border wall here soon if that interests you guys. I don't know why I always think it's so cool, but yeah, get to it. I was just about to record the sand blowing across the road here, and as soon as I did that, check engine light came on. I'm back in limp mode again, so I think there might be a spot to pull off here in a couple miles, but this is crazy to look at the sand blowing across the road like this as we're kind of entering the sand dunes now. I'm gonna pull off. I think there's an exit or something up here because I don't want to just pull over on the side of the interstate, but yeah, hopefully it's just something simple, but let's see. Okay, let's see, we got one code. It's either P1131 or P0101. If it's either of those, we're good. Ahaha, oh, that's a huge relief. Just means I need to clean my math, which I haven't done in a while, so we're good. But we're gonna go ahead and clear this. Maybe I'll buy some math cleaner in San Diego just to get it done. I might just need to buy a new math though if this keeps coming back. But yeah, not worried about that at all. That is awesome. About as good as it can get. Ah, I hit the wrong button. Erase codes. Yes. All right, and we should be all good to go. Let's go ahead and see. My camera would focus. There we go. All right. Finally getting off of I-8 after almost 300 miles, and of course I'm in traffic. Who would have thought? We're not even technically in San Diego yet, but yeah, so I'm gonna finish up these last 20 miles or so, and then when I park at my destination, or maybe I'll find a shopping center somewhere that's quiet, park, we'll check out how well this bug deflector did. I'll talk about how the car did after I cleared the code, and yeah, so see you guys in a few. All right, so just pulled up here. I stopped at a random like business park so I could find a nice quiet area. Of course, it's windy again though. But after I cleared that check engine light, it's been what, I think like 170 miles or so since then. 185.2 miles since I cleared the check engine light. Car ran absolutely perfectly. Cruise control didn't shut off or anything, so I'm 99.99% sure that it's going to be completely fine. So let's take a look at how good this bug deflector did, though. So if we look on our bumper, you'll see just how covered it is in bugs. It's actually not super, super bad. It's not good, though. But if we look at the bug deflector itself here, there's a pretty good amount of bugs on this thing. Now, the hood is very dirty. I can see all these little, you know, maybe where bugs did brush off of it, but there aren't any, like, dead bugs that are stuck on here that weren't done before. I mean, there might be, like, one or two. You can see how dirty the windshield is, too, kind of, if I can get the right angle. But this bug deflector worked extremely well, so I'm super happy with it. I think I'll still probably take it off, though, because I'm not a huge fan of how it looks. It also might have saved me from getting a couple rock chips, you know, because it's going to be good to deflect some rocks as well. Unfortunately, I didn't see a single sob the whole way here. I definitely would have gotten it in my B-roll if I did, but hopefully you guys enjoyed this video. I'm going to go enjoy my extended weekend now, and yeah, I love this car so much.